The government has rubbish claims the state's healthcare system is third world during an inquiry into delays at a public hospital's. Now, that's despite alarming evidence provided on the final day of an inquiry into ambulance ramping.
A health system in crisis.
The number of doctors who report making mistakes due to fatigue has gone up this year from the survey last year. Our doctors in ED and hospitals, they're burnt out, they're leaving the system.
Ambulance ramping and lack of beds back in the spotlight as the inquiry into state's emergency departments reveal just how crippled it is.
In your Prince of Wales Hospital, 32 emergency department staff have resigned this year.
Also, limited resources and little pay blamed for the mass exodus.
I could go and work in Queensland tomorrow and get an extra $50,000 in my hand.
The inquiry heard today another major problem is elective surgery wait times. The pandemic saw nearly 19,000 patients hold off on procedures longer than recommended. That's almost 10 times more than 2 years ago.
Poor outcomes for someone who then has their surgery and lives and is now disabled, is now in chronic pain, is now unable to work.
Some even losing their lives as a result of being left waiting.
The evidence is incredibly sober for everyone, and it should be a wake-up call for legislators.
Another fix is calling on pharmacists to help out overworked doctors and nurses. Their peak body recommends one to every 20 to 30 patients to help in emergency departments.
If you've got a pharmacist there, they can actually find out what the issue is and then resolve it from the ED and get them out of the ED under 4 hours.
Witnesses at the inquiry have previously labelled our health system third world, an allegation which was rejected.
New South Wales Health is not a third world health system.
I mean, those comments are very unhelpful and untrue. There's no doubt that the New South Wales health system is the strongest in the country.
When the inquiry will hand down its findings has not been decided. Han Nguyen for 10 News First.